Lifting Up Jesus and Opening His Word from Australia, Denmark, Israel, Japan, New Zealand, Northern Ireland, Republic of Ireland, Singapore, South Africa, United Kingdom, Thailand, the Philippines, United States, and throughout the world. You're watching Morial TV.
On Jubilees, we go into the mathematics of counting this time at length concerning the prophecies of Daniel chapter 9, where we deal with the 70 weeks. That is the Shemitot, the missing 7 years at the end of the age. Right now, the age of the church, which broadly corresponds to, but is not equal to, the time of the Gentiles, occurs between the 69th and 70th week of Daniel, largely. So the time of the Gentiles, let's say, is between the 69th and 70th week of Daniel. The 70th week is the last 7 years. Now, we have to understand something. In Hebrew and Aramaic, the word for week and the word for seven is basically the same. So it's 77s of years. 70 weeks of years equals 77s. We can account for 69 of them. Then we have this hiatus, which is the age of the, which is the time of the Gentiles, and then we have the final seven. During this final seven, something happens. The age of the church comes to an end in the beginning, and then the rapture takes place shortly after the first half, together with the resurrection. At that point, God's focus has totally shifted back to dealing with Israel and the Jews. It has not happened yet, but the stage is being set for it to happen. Now, we see the stage being set for it to happen in various different aspects, one of which is Romans 11, the increase in the numbers of Jews being saved in the last 25 to 35 years. That is a sign that the time of the Gentiles is coming to an end, that the age of the church will draw to a close, and that God is going to turn his position and his focus back to the salvation of Israel. Another is the rebirth of the nation of Israel in itself, and as importantly, if not more importantly, the unification of Jerusalem in 1967. Jesus spoke of Jerusalem being trampled down by the feet of the Gentiles. Now, it's still trampled down by the feet of the Gentiles because of the Temple Mount. Nonetheless, during this 70th week, we're going to see some kind of a reconstruction of a tribulational temple on the Temple Mount. To the best of my understanding, and I'm quite sure it's right, I point you to the book Harpazo. Nonetheless, it has not happened yet, but the stage is being set for it to happen. Be very careful of people who try to tell you the preterist or the extreme preterist position that these things have already happened and have no future meaning. That is utterly, utterly false. My name is Jacob Prash. Thank you for your question.